You are worthy to be praised, my Redeemer. You are worthy to be praised.
You are worthy to be praised. You are worthy to be praised, my Redeemer. You are worthy to be praised.
You are worthy, worthy to be praised.
You are worthy to be praised,
my Redeemer. You are worthy to be praised.
Our Redeemer, our helper, our supporter, our Lord of hosts, the one who had never lost a battle, we bless your holy name. Please accept our worship in Jesus' name. Today we have come before you, Lord, because you are the only one who can still every marital storm. Even as your children have come today, visit us in Jesus' name. Prove yourself in our lives in Jesus' name. And give us a new song to sing this month. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Well, let someone shout hallelujah. And then wave at one or two people and said, I will rejoice with you very soon. And so shall it be in Jesus' name. Let's be seated as we open our Bibles to 1 Samuel chapter 1. We'll be reading from verse 9 all the way to verse 20. 1 Samuel chapter 1 from verse 9 to 20. So Hannah rose up after they had eaten in Shiloh and after they had drunk. Now Eli the priest sat upon a seat by a post of the temple of the Lord. And she was in bitterness of soul and prayed unto the Lord and wept sore. And she vowed a vow and said, O Lord of hosts, if thou wilt indeed look on the affliction of thy handmaid and remember me and not forget thy handmaid, but will give unto thy handmaid a man child, then I will give him unto the Lord all the days of his life, and there shall no razor come upon his head. And it came to pass as she continued praying before the Lord that Eli marked her mouth. Now Hannah, she spake in her heart, only her lips moved, but her voice was not heard. Therefore Eli thought she had been drunken. And Eli said unto her, how long wilt thou be drunken? Put away thy wine from thee. And Anna answered and said, no, my Lord, I am a woman of a sorrowful spirit. I have drunk neither wine nor strong drink, but have poured out my soul unto the Lord. Count not thy handmaid for a daughter of Belial, for out of the abundance of my complaint and grief have I spoken hitherto. Then Eli answered and said, go in peace, and the God of Israel grant thee thy petition that thou hast asked of him. And she said, let thy handmaid find grace in thy sight. So the woman went away and did eat, and her countenance was no more sad. And they rose up in the morning early and worshipped before the Lord, and returned and came to their house to Ramah. And Elkanah knew Hannah his wife, and the Lord remembered her. Wherefore it came to pass, when the time was come about, after Hannah had conceived, that she bare a son, and called his name Samuel, saying, because I have asked him of the Lord. How do I get a marital storm permanently stilled? For a marital storm, and one of the ways that one could say one is in a serious marital storm is when you've prayed for children and they seem to refuse to come, as we see in the case of Hannah here. What and what do I need for the marital storm in my life to come to an end permanently? Number one, I need help from the Holy Spirit to pray correctly. Anna had been praying all manners of prayers in the past, and the answer didn't come. But on this occasion, she prayed a different kind of prayer, and God heard, and God responded. The Bible tells us in Romans chapter 8 verse 26, Romans 8 verse 26, that we don't know how to pray as we ought to. But thank God for the Holy Spirit that can help our infirmities, can help us to pray. My prayer for every one of us who have been crying to God all these days for the fruit of the womb is that God Himself, the Holy Spirit Himself, will help us to pray correctly today in Jesus' name. You need to pray correctly. It will take the Holy Spirit to do it for you, and He will do it for you today in Jesus' name. Second thing, of course, that you need is a decree from a man of God. Because here, Eli decreed. He said that your petition that you have asked of God, may God grant it to you. That's a decree. The Bible tells us in Job chapter 22 from verse 21 to 28, Job 22 from verse 21 to 28, that subject to certain conditions, you can decree a thing and it will be established unto you. But many a times that kind of decree comes through a man of God. For example, in 2 Kings chapter 4, verse 8 to 17, 2 Kings 4 from verse 8 to 17, in the story involving the Shunammite woman, there's no doubt about it that this Shunammite woman is a woman who feared God, a woman who loved. God. Then one day, the man of God made a decree and said, 9 months from now, you will embrace a son. The woman didn't believe. She told the man of God, don't deceive me. But a decree is a decree. And today, in the name that's above every other name, I hereby decree, 9 months from now, somebody here will shout for joy. The third thing that you need to still a marital storm is faith in God. Mark chapter 9 verse 23, Mark 9 23 says, if you can believe, all things are possible to him that believes. The moment Hannah had that decree coming from the man of God, the Bible says she was no longer sad. She was convinced beyond all doubt, at long last, I got it. And I'm saying to somebody here today, in the name that's above every other name, when you are sharing your testimony, you say, on that day, June the 7th of the year 2021, finally I got my own. The final thing you need, of course, is that you must fulfill your vow to God. Yes, Anna got a son, because she promised God, God, give me a son, I will give him back to you. And God responded, and she got the son. And then, in 1 Samuel chapter 2, from verse 20 to 21, 1 Samuel 2, verse 20 to 21, she fulfilled her vow. And when she did that, the Bible said God gave her 5 additional children. When you talk of barrenness, nobody can ever believe that Hannah used to be barren. I am believing God for someone here today that one day, very soon, when you are coming to church and your car seats at the back are full of your children, nobody will believe that you used to be barren, because the Almighty God will put a permanent end to barrenness in your life. And so we're about to pray. What I want to do today is I just want to issue a decree. After I've issued the decree, you will cry to God with all your heart, asking the Holy Spirit, help me to pray today. Let me pray correctly. And I'm trusting the Almighty God, the one who will not let the voice or the word of God in the mouth of his prophet fall to the ground. I'm trusting God that I will be hearing your testimony very soon. Before we pray, of course, just in case there is anyone who is not yet a child of God in our midst, I will encourage the fellow to run forward very quickly before I say fall and come and give his or her life to Jesus Christ to ask for salvation. Because salvation must come before the decree of God can begin to operate in your life. So if you are here and you are not sure of your salvation, or you are a backslider and you want to return to God, before I say fall, come and stand before me. We'll pray for your salvation first, and then we will issue the decree, and the Almighty God will begin to do marvelous things in your life. So if you want to surrender your life to Jesus, just in case there's anyone, I'm counting between 1 and 4. Make sure you are here before I say four, and we'll pray for your salvation. I'm counting now. One. Oh, you need salvation before fruitfulness, so you must come. Two. Three. Okay, now those of you who have come forward, go ahead and talk to the Lord. Ask him to please save your soul. Ask him to wash away any sin that can stand between you and your miracle today. Ask him to make you a child of God in spirit and in truth. Promise him that from now on you will serve him. And the rest of us, please, let's stretch our hands towards our brothers and intercede for them, that the Almighty God will save their soul, and anything standing between them and fruitfulness, God will wipe it away with his blood today and give them a brand new beginning. Let's pray for them, brethren. Just for 2 minutes, intercede for them. And those of us in front, cry to the Almighty God, I've come to surrender my life to you. Please receive me, save my soul. Let your blood wash me clean. I will serve you for the rest of my life. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. My Father, my God, I want to bless your holy name because I know that you are the Savior of mankind. And you said, whosoever will come unto you, you will no wise cast out. These your children have come now. Please receive them. Save their souls. Let your blood wash away their sins. Please write their names in the book of life and give them a brand new beginning. And from now on, anytime they cry unto you, please answer them by fire. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Now, those of you who have come forward, I rejoice with you. If you will turn to your left, you see a sister holding a placard. Kindly follow her. She will collect certain information I need from you and then bring you back very quickly. God bless you. Let's give the Lord a big, big round of applause. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Oh, glory be to God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Now, as is our practice, if you don't mind, come towards the altar. I'm going to just issue some decrees before you now begin to talk to God on your own. And today I'm sure you will pray hard, you will pray long, because the Holy Spirit himself will guide you how to pray, so that you will pray correctly and the answer will come speedily in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Be to God. Maybe for just 1 minute you want to thank God in advance for what he's about to do now, because I believe he's about to give you a breakthrough this morning. So for just about 2 minutes, thank him in advance. Say, Lord, I'm thanking you now because I believe that today my breakthrough will come. Just for 2 minutes, thank him, and then I will issue my own decrees. So, thank you, Savior. Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. My Father, my God, we are thanking you in advance because we believe in you. We believe you are the Almighty. We believe you are the Lord of hosts. We believe you have never lost a battle. We know you have made us more than conquerors. Father, accept our thanks in Jesus' name. In your name, my Father, my God, I decree concerning these your children, this very day, hear their prayer. The Almighty God, the maker of heaven and earth, the one who said, I am the Lord of all flesh, and there's nothing too hard for me to do. That God will answer you today. That God will remember you today. That God will open your womb today. That God will put an end to barrenness in your life. That God will make you the mother, the father of many children. Barrenness will no longer be mentioned in your family. Very soon, you will return to testify. It shall be well with you. Within a year, you shall return. And you and your children will serve God forever. So shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name, I have decreed. Amen. Now go ahead, cry to God, tell him your, from the bottom of your heart, pour out your heart to him. God, help me. Holy Spirit, help me to pray now. Let me pray the correct prayer today. Go ahead, talk to the Almighty God and talk to him. And when you have prayed and you are satisfied, you just drop your offering on your way out. But cry to him now. Lord God Almighty, blessed Holy Spirit, let me pray the correct prayer today, so that today will be my own day of victory.